News. On point. News on XFM. I'm Chris Otim. The National Resistance Movement has welcomed the decision by the former presidential candidate Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu to withdraw his presidential election petition. The NRM spokesperson Rogers Mulindwa says Kyagulanyi has deemed it important to withdraw the case rather than wasting court's time to hear a petition which lacks enough evidence to overturn the presidential election's results.
Is a plus for him, and I want to congratulate him. When you realize that you are walking a wrong path, there is no danger in turning back. This case had so many weaknesses. There were so many loopholes. First of all, Honorable Kyagulanyi is aware that where he won, even the MPs elect went through. Where we lost, we also lost with the MPs. So why would you waste time going to the courts of law? To do what? When the biggest court, the people's court, had decided. Uganda has voted for NRM. So I think the decision is very wise, and I want to congratulate him. You know, Uganda is here. Uganda is not going away tomorrow. Let us be supportive to the government in power.
Relatedly, the acting spokesperson of the Electoral Commission, Paul Bukenya, says that they have not yet received the petition, but their lawyers will study it and respond accordingly.
In this matter, which is before court, we are represented as the Electoral Commission. We have our lawyers who are following up this matter. And because that is the, as Electoral Commission, we will wait for their briefing on this matter and how it is going to be handled, because we are represented as an Electoral Commission. We cannot comment on the issues which are before court, including the said action by the petitioner. I think we will get to know more details as we are briefed by our lawyers. But as Electoral Commission, we're waiting for that kind of brief. At this moment, we cannot say much about it until we get to understand and we go through the processes for withdrawal of the case.
Bekasese District Health Officer Yusuf Baseke has said that the already existing COVID-19 standard operating procedures, SOPs, will help the district to guard against the Ebola disease. His comments follow a confirmed fresh outbreak of Ebola in the Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo, DRC, in the North Kivu province. Kasese is one of the districts in Uganda that neighbors DRC with a lot of cross-border business, especially at the Mpondwe border post. Baseke says the wearing of face masks, washing of hands and social distancing due to a coronavirus will do a great deal in the infection prevention and control of Ebola. According to Baseke, the population has been sensitized on how the Ebola transmission can be interrupted. He added that despite the cross-border trade between Uganda and DRC, all individuals that cross to Uganda are subjected to a mandatory screening. Police have appealed to the border cyclists to come up and report those who are involved in grabbing mobile phones and stealing handbags in jam. This has been rampant in different areas of Kampala, where people pretend to be border cyclists and go on grabbing items from passengers on the roadside. The Kampala Metropolitan Police Eastern CLO, Yakub Wachisada, says that they have started talking to the border leaders at different stages to trace those who are involved in these acts.
I wish to congratulate to our fellow border people. They do help us a lot in transporting people. However, there are those ones who come with intention of stealing. They go pulling people's bags, ladies. Actually, the main victims, they are women, because they know they are weak. So I encourage border chairpersons in the various stages in town to take interest in these border people who comes around and they want to pick passengers.
In wild news, the wife of the jailed Mexican drug lord Joaquim El Chapo Guzman has been arrested in the United States on suspicion of drug trafficking, U.S. authorities say. Emma Coronel Ispuro, age 31, was detained at Dulles International Airport outside of Washington, D.C. She is charged with participating in conspiracy to distribute cocaine, metamphetamine, heroin, and marijuana. Guzman is currently serving a life sentence in New York for drug trafficking and money laundering. The 63-year-old is a former head of the Sinaloa cartel, which officials say was the biggest supplier of drugs to the U.S. His trial in 2019 had shocking revelations about his life, from drugging and raping girls as young as 13 to carrying out cold-blooded murders of former cartel members and rivals. In sports, Christian Benteke scored a late goal as Crystal Palace beat Brighton 2-1 in a Premier League game played last night. A Brighton defender, Joel Weltman, says the man of their Premier League defeat by Crystal Palace felt like a robbery that has pushed them towards the danger zone. The Dutch internationals swept in an equaliser for the Seagulls after Jean-Philippe Matete had earlier backheeled Palace in front from their first real attack in that game. And that's the latest XFM News.
XFM News on point.